2 weeks later, the frame is almost complete. Catherine's house is now emerging from the treetops and can hold its own on the Falmouth hillside. There's no roof yet, but the team press on, forming the openings for the windows. A remarkably simple job in a timber frame.
There you go, then.
Despite there being no roof, Catherine appears to be extraordinarily relaxed.
You are?
I'm used to dealing normally with about four projects at once. Most of my projects have come to an end outside of the house now. So having this, it's been quite fun, I guess, in comparison.
But as conditions get worse, I find it difficult to see the fun, and Chris tells a different story.
Catherine's amazingly calm and laid back, but she's amazingly good at believing that she's not stressed. Amazingly good. But she is. She's pretty stressed. I know this, but not a lot of people get to see it.
By the end of November, I can see just how much the team have pulled together. Catherine seems to be totally in control, but I do wonder whether the wet weather is playing havoc with the timber frame.
Are you happy about the amount of water that you've got in this building at the moment?
I'm happy enough because this is waterproof flooring, so it shouldn't warp, which the guys encouraged me to buy because they said a lot of people always do have lots of problems, and I took their advice, I'm glad I did. It's winter, unfortunately, and...
Sadly it is, and you put up a timber frame with no roof on it.
With no roof. It's a bit of a frustration.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, we're going the speed we were hoping to go. The guys have been amazing. They've worked through all weather.
So when did you put the roof on? When did you put the lid on it?
In about a week, hopefully, weather depending.
In the meantime, Yanni and the boys aim to clad the whole structure in a cedar strip. That is, if they can get it down the drive.
Because when I zoomed in on Google, it looked flat. And that's about 1 in 3, isn't it? So there's no way I'm going to be able to get down there, my friend.
There's only one thing for it. While Catherine directs traffic, it's up to the rest of us to carry it all down to site. I seem to be doing more than my fair share of work on this project.
Nice wood. Nice smelling wood. It's got a perfume, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's lovely.
Really beautiful.
Very fragrant.
This is a fancy profile, isn't it?
Yeah, I had to do a little bit of discussions with the manufacturer.
Why? So what's the deal?
It's just a secret fix profile, basically, so that we won't see the nail heads.
Now, how many square metres have you got to do, you know?
155, which is 2,616 linear metres.
I just knew you had the answer.
Catherine's attention to every tiny detail will benefit this building no end. But for Yanni, her main contractor, there is, of course, no room for error.
How is Catherine as a client to work with? Because she's very fussy, isn't she?
She is very fussy, but I'd rather have a client that knows exactly what they want.
Seriously?
Definitely. It makes my job a lot easier. I knew what I was stepping into when I started the project, but... Yeah, I love the challenge and giving the client exactly what they want as well, because, hey, if we're lucky enough in our lives, we get to build our dream house, so let's try and get it right for those people, you know? Perfect.
Hey, look, I have to show you this. Look, we unclip. There are the nails. But look at this. Look, this is the Gatling gun of construction, this.
It's big boys' toys.
I love that.
When I first met Catherine, I was concerned that she was taking on a huge responsibility here, single-handedly managing the project, but she is more than holding her own, so far.
Is the schedule then bang on at the moment?
The windows were meant to arrive this week, but because of a small change that we had to make, they're now arriving on Tuesday, which is...
Hey, wow.
I can't really complain.
5 days
exactly. It's not
that's
that
shocking.
Late. No, it's going all right, actually. I mean, the thing that we were hoping to have the roof on by now, but the weather's been atrocious, so that's going to be as and when.
And the budget is that equally under control?
Yeah, I hate saying this, but we're like £4,000 under at the moment, which is nice.
Don't be worried about saying that. Shout it.
Shout it from your
plywood balcony to the world. Because that's fantastic.
Catherine is absolutely across this project. She is no princess, but a queen of construction. And I have high expectations of things to come.
There is a breed of interior designer that takes more of an interest in, cushions and silk lampshades than they do in architecture and the bones of a building. But Catherine Mercer is not really part of that breed. Of course, like all of us, she's a sucker for style, but at the same time, she's really passionate about it. She takes an interest in the way her building's put together. And you roll all that together, and it really does augur well, doesn't it?